Okay, so if we're going to multiply and divide complex numbers, again, complex numbers being some real number plus some imaginary number, a plus bi. All right. If it's a plus bi, that's called standard form. We want the trigonometric CIS form. So first thing you want to do, the key to this process is you want to make sure both numbers are in trigonometric form. If they aren't, you want them to be. Okay. And to make the trigonometric form, we do just like we did yesterday. You find the magnitude of the complex number, how long it is. You find the reference angle alpha. You figure out what quadrant it's in. There's, you find theta. And then once you've got all that stuff, then you've got your something CIS some angle times something CIS some angle. All right. We're going to either multiply or divide trigonometric structures. And all you have to do to multiply is real simple. You're going to multiply the magnitudes to get the new magnitude. You're going to add the angles to get the new angle. When you start adding angles, there's a possibility the angle ends up being bigger than 360, or if you're in radians, bigger than 2 pi. If that should happen, if it's between 0 and 360, or I should say 0 degrees, and that should be there. 0 radians and 2 pi, or 0 degrees and 360 degrees, between that. Then if it's bigger than 360 or 2 pi, you're going to subtract 360 or 2 pi again and again and again until you get between zero, between your correct value, right? Less than 360 degrees, less than 2 pi radians. On the division one, you're going to divide the magnitudes to get the new magnitude, and you're going to subtract the top minus the bottom angle to get the new angle. When you start subtracting, you have the possibility of getting a negative angle. If that should happen, if the angle is less than 0 degrees or 0 radians, you add 360 or 2 pi again and again and again until it gets to be a positive number. That's going to be the answer you're looking for. And the last thing is make sure you give the answer in the form they're asking for. So if they ask for the answer in trigonometric form, it should look like this. If it's asking for it in standard form, it should be some number plus something I. So 2 plus 3i is standard form. 5 CIS 90 degrees is trigonometric form. So give me the proper form on the answer. Example 1, or 5. Multiply the complex numbers 2 cosine 30 plus I sine 30 times 3 cosine 225 plus I sine 225. This is the expanded form of the trigonometric structure. This is being multiplied by this. And the first thing I personally would do is change it to 2 CIS 30 degrees times 3 CIS 225. Just for the sake of writing it, it's much, much more concise to write it that way. It makes it easier to look at. We are multiplying the complex numbers. The technique for multiplication states that to get the something CIS something, right? We're looking for a number CIS some angle. To get the number out in front, we're going to multiply the magnitudes. 2 times 3 makes 6. To get the angle, I'm going to add the two angles. 30 plus 225 is 255. It says write the answer in trigonometric form, which is this. 255 is between 0 and 360, so we're good to go. If this angle had been 300 plus 225, all of a sudden makes 525. Now you got to subtract 360 to get it between 0 and 360. Okay, you always want the angle between 0 and 360 when you're in degrees.